I'm Joe from ITProTV, and I know you've heard and you're probably looking for more information about the ITIL 4 update and the qualifications, certifications that there are with ITIL 4. Well, I've got a little bit more information for you here. So as we know, ITIL 4 is due to be launched, or at least it's going to start to be launched in the beginning, the first quarter of 2019. So let's take a look at the certificate, shall we? So right at the very bottom, you'll see that we have got ITIL Foundation, and that is going to be exactly the same format as the version 3 2011 format. That's going to be a 40-question, one-hour exam, multiple-choice exam. But then after Foundation, that launches in quarter 1 in 2019, we then have what we will call the modules, if you want to call them intermediates, as it were, within version 3 and 2011. That's how we referred to them. And you'll see that ITIL then splits into two streams. Now, these two streams are going to be available in the second half of 2019. We don't have any exact dates yet, but you can see that on the left-hand side of the screen there, we've got the ITIL Managing Professional and the ITIL Strategic Leader. And you can choose either one of those streams. And in order to become a managing professional, you will have to also take the specialist modules and the strategic module. That includes the create, deliver, and support, and the drive stakeholder value, and the high velocity. And you will also have to take the ITIL strategist, the direct, plan, and improve. Now, if you want to become a strategic leader, then you'll have to take the ITIL leader of digital and IT strategy, and you'll have to take the ITIL strategist, the direct, plan, and approve. You can see that that one in Navy is actually, well, that's exactly the same for both of those streams. So you have two streams there, and you have to, if you want to become an ITIL master, be both a managing professional and a strategic leader, in order to then qualify to take the ITIL Master certification, if that's what you want to go on and do. Now, in terms of comparison to version 3 or 2011, you'll see that we've got the Managing Professional stream there and you've got the Strategic Leader stream there. Well, they are at exactly the same level as we would consider the ITIL Expert right now. So that's the version 3 2011 ITIL Expert. And the ITIL Master is at exactly the same level as the ITIL Master that we have within version 3 2011. So what we have are the modules sort of in the middle, in that pink and the navy blue there. They are in place of the intermediates. Now, what about those of you that have got either an ITIL Expert or are currently working through the 2011 ITIL Expert track? Because I know that that's a question that many of you have. My advice to you is don't stop. Do not stop to gain your version 3 2011 credits. You'll notice here that we have got an extra qualification on this slide, and that is the Managing Professional Transition. At the moment, in version 2011, you are earning credits for every single intermediate and for foundation and practitioner. So every single exam that you are taking, you are earning credits, either 2 credits or 3 credits or 4 credits if you're doing something like release control and validation. And you know that you have to earn 17 credits in order to be able to take the managing across the life cycle qualification. Well, if you have 17 credits in version 2011 or version 3, or if you are an ITIL expert already, then you are then eligible to take the Managing Professional Transition. And that particular qualification will then make you an ITIL Managing Professional. So let me just repeat that again. Don't stop taking your version 3 2011 certifications. Because if you amass 17 credits, or for those of you that are already an ITIL expert, then you will be eligible in the second half of 2019, when the qualifications become available, when they're released. If you're an ITIL expert or you have 17 credits, you will be eligible to take the Managing Professional Transition qualification, and that will transition you to a managing professional. So I know this is a question that a lot of people are asking right now, but what do I do with my existing qualification? Don't stop. Carry on with your track and you will be able to take that transition. Now, unfortunately, there is no transition at foundation level. That said, foundation exam is 40 questions and an hour long. So really, that shouldn't be too much of a challenge. It shouldn't be too much of a leap for you. And of course, here at ITProTV, we will have all of these qualifications available for you. We'll have all of these courses available for you. As soon as they are released to the general public, then we will make sure that we release them to you. So keep an eye out here on our news at ITProTV. And as soon as we have more information, then I will guarantee that I will be bringing it straight to you. Thank you for watching.